got adjusted. Hey, you guys. I've got a pillow. Hi. How are you guys doing this afternoon? It's beautiful out there, but it's a little bit cold. But that brings a lot of beautiful flowers this time of year. That's springtime is my favorite time of year. The buds on the tree start growing and the flowers. I'm a big flower person. I don't know about you guys, but I don't remember any of the names of the flowers, but I can tell you I pretty much like every single one. You know, my husband, not big into it. You know, he barely smells them. I'm not sure that he thinks they smell very good at all. Actually, yesterday he mentioned there's some really pretty purple ones in our backyard, and he actually said they smelled good, so I need to go out there and smell them. I remember in college, you know, I had to give him the big elbow and tell him, hey, you know, I like flowers, you know. I don't mind if you give them to me anytime. Anyway, so, hey, how are you guys doing? Welcome to Bead with me today. I'm definitely running way late, so thanks for joining me here anyway. I am here kind of alone in the store. I've let all the employees, you know, stay safe and be at home. I've been chatting with them, so all of our people are safe. So, you know, I have had people calling and asking, so we appreciate you guys reaching out to us. But we are all doing fine. However, we are, you know, having to be apart. What are you going to do? So, we are here playing, and I had somebody kind of knock on the door and decided they need to have their bead fix. And so I opened up the door and let them have a little quick shopping spree. And so you guys are allowed to do that. We kind of usually do appointment based, but I generally tend to be here from 12 to 3 right now, so you can get that cool online experience. So if you wish you could be in the bead store and want to give me a video chat, do it. Okay, pick up the phone. You can do it really easily. It connects really quickly. Okay, so today I thought we'd do a nice little combination of beads. So it's kind of a button bracelet, and it's kind of using a lot of the beads that I have been using. So kind of showing you how you can be using a lot of your leftovers to make a lot of variety of different styles of bracelets and necklaces and wearable art. Okay, so the first thing I was starting out with was a button, which in this case I did a gold button. So you can see here I was kind of working on it here. So just did a gold button. And I'm going to show you today, I'm using some cotton cording. Okay, this is a 1 millimeter. Comes in a lot of fun colors. We have, well, that's not a fun color. Let's try. We have some peaches, some pinks. Okay, this is a 1 millimeter. So you can use a variety of cords. I thought I'd change it up and use a little bit of cotton. Okay, with the cotton to do our endings, we're going to use some super new glue. If you guys don't have super new glue, highly recommend it. Needs to pretty much be in your stash. Okay, one of those basics you got to have. Okay, and then I am having a variety of beads that fit on it. Okay, so I started pulling out some of those zeros. Okay, those actually had a good decent size hole. Remember in the rings and memory wire, we use those O's. I'm also going to use some size 6 seed beads. Okay, and then I'm also going to use, let's see, I'll flash around so you can kind of see some of the components I'm using. So I'm going to use some O's here today. I'm sorry, they're called zeros, also like O's. Both, I think, checkmate. Okay, and then I'm going to use what we call cornerless rounds. Okay, cornerless cubes, I guess they are. So if you imagine a cube and then they cut off all the corners, that makes it a nice little facet. Okay, and then I've chosen a variety of some nice pewter beads that I think have good size holes just to give this some interest. Okay, so to give you an idea, this is what I've stranded so far. Okay, we're gonna see what this turns out like. Okay, so these bead with me's are just kind of fun, give you something that you can pull out of your box, maybe get you started, hopefully get you motivated to be making something. Okay, so I will show you how we got started. Okay, so first thing we're doing is we're going to take a button. Okay, this one happens to have a shank. You can also use ones that have the two holes also through it. Okay, I don't have one sitting right here, but you can use it the same. Well, I'm going to cut two pieces of cording because I want to do four strands in this particular one and want to make it fun, and I really like the multi-strand look here. Okay, this is kind of like the tassel one we made yesterday. Okay, so I'm going to do about 2 feet. Where's my cutter? So I'm just kind of guesstimating. Two pieces here. All right. Now the first thing I'm gonna do is take this button and get this tied onto there. Okay, I'm gonna start in the middle. And tie a knot onto this baby. Okay, and I always don't mind having a little bit of an ending here because you want to be able to have an room for that loop to kind of go around at the end. Okay, now the second cord, you guys, now that we have this one. In this one, I'm going to flip around so maybe you can see this move a little bit easier. Okay, so we made that first tie here. And take the second one, lay it through, even that up. Okay, I'm gonna tie a square knot. So I'm gonna do a left over right. Helps if it's on the button here. Okay, once the beads are on here, this will be better. Okay, so left over right, right over left. Okay, and all your cords tied together here. Okay, so I've just tied one knot and then now I've tied the second. Okay, so that gives us the four cords and a little bit of room for when that button gets hooked in. Okay, so now I have these nice four cords. Okay, want them to be about even. Okay, now on the tips of these cords, okay, we want to put a little bit of super new glue on the tips of these. Okay, what that's going to do is help the edges from fraying. Okay, as well as hardening the tip so it kind of makes like a needle. Sometimes you will also deal with kind of a blunt edge here. Okay, so it's nice because you can, once this dries, you can clip this at an angle, it'll make more like a needle, kind of like the that tip here. Okay, so that's how we get started. And now, we're stringing. I'm gonna hang out and string for a little bit. I have chosen some of those zeros. I did some of the, I'm doing a gold and silver combination since I tend to be a silver person, but I always like mixing metals too. Feels like it ends up making it more versatile. So in this strand right now, I am kind of doing some different colors here. So I am going to throw in this bracelet. I'm going to measure as I go here. So this is already close to six. So I'm going to maybe string on another half an inch here. Since an average bracelet is 7 inches. Okay, so I'm done with these kind of blue O's. Maybe I'll do some of these bright colors. The size sixes have such nice, good size holes. Big holes, easy to string this 1 millimeter. So I'm kind of doing big segments here today. I'm just thinking color. I always like color. And if you guys can't tell, purple and teal are my favorite colors. See, I went with the new polish today. Teal and sparkles, those are my favorite. So we're gonna keep stringing here. So I did a little segment of greens. I think I'm just gonna kind of wait till the end, kind of fit it around myself here. So oftentimes people are asking, what size should I make it? Mm-hmm. You know, the best way is to kind of guesstimate. There's always average sizes, but you know, most of us are pretty much not average in some way, shape, or form. So it's always a little bit hard to guess even for us. Okay, so I'm measuring about seven inches here all the way to the edge of the button. Okay, so I've got kind of four little sections here, and now I'm going to start on another strand, and we'll do some other colors. So this time I think I'm going to do some gold, bring some gold into this. Like, I thought these gold cubes were pretty cool. And the beautiful thing is you really can't go wrong. You know, can go through your stash and start pretty much poking holes. A lot of things can fit a 1 millimeter, a little bit more than maybe you'd think. This one I think I can maybe use a little bit more glue on the end here. But yeah, I really like cubes too. I don't know about you guys, but I don't use a whole lot of rounds unless I need to space something. I'm just gonna move on to the next bead. I think I'm going to put a little bit more glue onto this one while I wait for that to dry here. I'm going to start on maybe another strand
And that one, let's see, shall we use some pinks, some purples? Maybe this red. This is a pretty cool color. This is great. This uses up a lot of different shapes and styles of beads. And again, you can't really go wrong here. I've got these teal ones I'm gonna use. And some of these purples. I really like these O beads. Colors look so good. All right, so we'll do some red ones here while that one dries. All right, so this is a cutting it at the angle. So this one. Okay, you can kind of see that sharp edge here. And then I'm gonna kind of flatten it down just a smidgen to help make sure it fits through those holes here as we make a little needle. So that'll be the same thing on the ends. You'll want to just glue it so that the ends don't fray on you. This cotton, though, strings up, holds up well, strings up nice. So you could do different cordings. You could have used a 1 millimeter leather as well. Should we do, let's see how some of these. We'll do some of these. These are really fun, pretty ones. Maybe I'll do some of these teal O's. Now the O's are a little bit smaller. So what I'll do is flatten that out just a smidgen so we can make it around. When I cut it, I had made it flattened a little bit. Back in the day, they used to have seed beads on strands, and so people who did beaded flowers, you know, you could just grab those. Grab a little section of them and then string them on, making stringing a little bit faster. But that's a time-consuming process, so you don't see very many Hanks anymore. We carry some Hanks here. We posted some of the size 13 Charlottes that we have, but they're kind of almost like a collector's item these days. So, you know, I'm kind of doing big chunks of color. I'm kind of being very random right now, because that's kind of the fun. You know, 90% of the population tends to be symmetrical. So that means you always want it to have kind of that balance, equal on both sides. But that asymmetrical look, I have difficulty creating it. And so that's a skill. Just practicing and doing is the best way. The best way to do that. All right, so now I'm gonna do some of these cool little metal beads. So you can see as my design is falling onto here. I like this project because, you know, I'm not a big seed beater. So doing a lot of the stitches and stuff, it tends to be pretty time consuming, and you know, with a five-year-old running around and keeping up with you guys, I don't have a lot of extra free time, and so I'm big on to, it's kind of like cooking. I'm big into kind of 5-minute meals or 30 things that you can make in like 30 minutes, that sort of thing. And so I kind of like my jewelry that way, now that I come to think of it. Now, I wish I was as good in my kitchen, however, as I was here with you guys in the shop. Let's see, now I think I'll do some of this. But I wish I was as good in my kitchen. You know, there's some people who just, you know, open up their cabinets and they just pull this and then they pull that and then voila, they have this beautiful meal, you know. I wish I could do that. You know, you hand me some beads though, I feel like I could probably put something together and look at least halfway decent. How's that looking, you guys? I don't have the gold in there, so I know right now it looks a lot of silver, but just obviously I like I'm doing some funky, maybe this one I'll throw some. Mom? Yes, dear. Yes. Did you finish eating your food? Uh-huh. You did, huh? Mm-hmm. Cool. Yeah. Okay, I need you to be a big, strong, smart boy. Make sure you've eaten that good food. Okay? Alright, so this one I'm gonna... You did? You ate it all? That's great.
No. The whole...
Oh, okay. Good. That makes Mama happy. I've been watching some of these bloopers on the news channels and seeing some of these newscasters and having the world be on live TV and working remotely and seeing that everybody has their kids at home and jumping into the screen and the newscasters having to tell them, hold on 1 second, honey. And then tell people, oh, I feel just like that. I completely understand. Only I don't have that many viewers that hopefully we're gaining here. Since I am now your new beadcaster here from Stars Beads, showing you fun designs, things that you can do with your stash, quick and easy projects. A lot of us, I know, even though we are at home and working remotely, we're still working. Okay, there's some gold. I like that. Okay, now let's see what bead do I need. Let's see. Maybe I will put some of these pink ones. These pink O's. And then we'll have... Maybe my other strand will have dried here. This one I'm doing as kind of a multi-color. So as I'm balancing, to my eyes, I'm trying to balance. So we were talking about being symmetrical and asymmetrical. This is kind of trying to almost close your eyes and just string some beads on. So this is a good one sitting in front of the TV or doing our Netflix. I know there's been some incredible surges in certain markets. I'm sure Amazon is doing just fine. Netflix is doing just fine. Zoom is doing just fine. I figure this time of day, you know, it's kind of like this coffee break. It's tough working from home. Those that are working remotely, it kind of gives you a new idea of, you know, kind of what it's like for some people of having to have that self-motivation. You know, it's one, there's something to say about having to go into the office. You get up in the morning and then you're driving into work. Oftentimes that can be your preparation time. You can be thinking about what that speech is, what you gotta say, you know, and then you can get into work. Working from home, man, staying in those pajamas, it's just so enticing. But yet at the same time, you know, it's so easy just to stay in those pajamas, right? All right, so I'm just kind of seeing how much more I need here at the end. I think I'm gonna do a few of these silver beads, cornerless cubes. I've been enjoying these projects. A lot of these I oftentimes want to make up and show you guys, and I don't feel like I have enough time to do it. I just have enough time to tell you guys how to do it, and hopefully you guys go home and make some. All right, I think we've got that second strand. I think that's gonna be really pretty. All right, I got this other strand started here. Okay, so this one. So as we're stringing things, you can kind of see how they're gonna line up here. So as I'm stringing, I'm letting it lay there so I can get an idea of, oh, you know, maybe I don't want to be doing the spacing all about the same, so maybe I'll just do a few of those cubes. Now I'll move to, we have a purple and a teal. Maybe I'm gonna go with, actually maybe I'll go right into some more metal beads. Here's the color I wanted to use. Ooh, pretty. I've just got a pretty mess of beads right here. And this one, I have to cut the edge. Okay. This one I had put a little bit more glue, so the tip was a little bit stiffer a longer way down. So depending on how long some of your beads are, then I had just done the very, very tips. But as you're working and stuff, it kind of wears on that, on there, so you may redo it. That's why you want to always try to give yourself more than enough room at the end. You know, I did the 2 feet. You could certainly do a little bit more. All right, there's a lot of gold in one place, huh? All right, so let's do some color, though. Let's see. I'm going to do this purple shade here. Maybe some of these purple O's over here. You can see those. See them sliding down. Almost to our third one. So makes up pretty fast. So all we're using today are hopefully some of your leftovers, some cording that may be sitting around. Today I'm using a 1 millimeter cord, so if you guys are just kind of still joining in with me, we're making a fun bracelet here. Bump in there. Couldn't get it through real easily. That happens sometimes here. All right, we're gonna be getting to the end soon enough here. Now you could do this with gemstones. I'm using all glass here today and metal, but you could certainly use anything. Purple and gold. I went to JMU. Those were my school colors. Hard not watching any of the sports. I did a lot of individual sports, so I guess ones that you could have kept that 6 feet of distance. I guess if you're a runner, you could probably keep that about a distance. All right, there's some purple in there. Okay, what do we think? Shall we throw a few of these silver beads in there that are smooth? Like these kind of chunks of section here. Okay, do a little bit of that. Now let's see. Now I might go to a few. Is that falling next to? Opened here and the seed beads. Did one. I did some red. I did green. I did the purple. I did a yellow. Okay, I haven't done this color here. These tubes of seed beads can go really far. Nice little segment. I think I'm gonna do like I'm missing a color of these O's or something. Have the three colors. Maybe now I'm gonna try some of these. What do we think of those? These gold. Those gold beads look good. Okay, we're getting done almost with the third strand. All right, what do we think? Close, not quite. This is what we've got so far here. Kind of a little mishmash. Some fun beads. Wonder if I left that. How do we like that coming so far? Huh? So this one, I think we just need to add a little color. So this one, I'm gonna end with some of these teal O's. Worn down the edge a little bit here. This is a great design also to kind of play with some different textures. So you can see, I've got some things with designs. Texture and pattern can be difficult. I tend to wear pretty solid designs and then jewelry that is different. I have a hard time wearing paisleys and things with a lot of things going on. Maybe because I've worn jewelry a lot of my life, and so. Ooh, this looks so good. All right, I think I need a little bit more on there. I think I'm gonna. Really like these little silver beads. These were designed off of the Thai silver beads with the little stamps on them. And you can see how tiny these are and how big that hole is. I'm just rather surprised. I was pulling beads and you'd be surprised that you can actually fit this cord through there. I wasn't sure in the package. I liked them, but alright, I think that's getting close. And this is beady. I can kind of add them at the end if I need to. So I'll just take one off of there. All right, we're on our last strand. Let's see, I'm going to start off with this silvery design. So here I'm starting, and since I had some color there, I'm going to start with metal on this last one. Then we're gonna have a bracelet before dinner and still have time to play in the garden. So I'm stringing on this little design here. So doing some now. I was talking to somebody earlier here. See how this has a big hole? So the only thing that happens with the big hole is that obviously it can move around a little bit, okay? So it means it can kind of drop on the string. So you can see here, I've put something that has a slightly smaller hole next to it, and it kind of plugs up right next to it, therefore holding it in place, okay, so that it doesn't drop. So you won't even notice that it is a bigger hole, to be honest. The movement isn't always bad. That kind of, it's organic that way. Some holes are just not always perfect, so I'm running into a couple holes here on here that are not making it quick here. Okay, so the nice thing about those big hole beads is that they're big and they string up quickly. So those with bad eyesight, this can be a good one because you can just pick out ones that have bigger size holes and string this up pretty quickly. All right, do a little segment there so you can see things as they're falling. I think I'm gonna go into a small section of this. This one I'm gonna do kind of short sections of it. This one I had cut off the end here. So cut off that corner again. Find it easier to string. So I'll do some. So this one I'm gonna mix a little bit of teal and a little bit of the metal beads. Now you can shake it up a little bit. Looks pretty cool. Alright, now I'm going to move into maybe a red color tone. A little section of red. Seeing kind of almost what I have left over here. Isn't this just a beautiful palette of color? We're almost on our fourth strand. We're going to be having to end this and we'll be finished. Okay, nice little section of red. I think I'm going to do a couple of these gold beads here. I'm going to do five of those. Okay. We'll move into a, put in a little bit of the pink next. So I'm going to put some pink O's in here. Put a few of those pinks down. Those look pretty. And that I will put maybe a couple of the gold. gold beads to separate it like I did with the gel. I like the way that looked. Teal beads in. All right, more than halfway. I'm gonna put the rest of these teal ones on there. This section here, I think I can use a few gold beads. Maybe this will do a combination. What do we think? Gold and silver combo. Do we like that? See how that looks. I like that. Probably could have done a combo in some other sections. But that's what makes it so random. I tend to be symmetrical, so I'm trying to work out of my element. Using a whole bunch of different shapes, a whole bunch of different colors, components, styles. So we've got metal, we've got glass, got some cotton cord here. Okay, what do we think here? Okay, ending on a color. What color should I end on? Okay, it can't be that green color. How about yellow? Yeah. We'll end with the rest of what I have of these guys. And we just have a couple left that I see. I think I can only put four. That's okay. Make it. Close. Ooh, doesn't that look fun? Alright, I think that this one needs just a little smidgen more. So this one will end with some of these. Yellow green. I don't even know what to call those. Wrong color. Okay, so I'm just eyeballing. I'm trying to get these about the same length here. So when we tie them, they'll be kind of looking kind of even. Okay, but again, you do not have to make this super stressful. It's okay if these have some movement. Okay, the bigger thing is that it fits you. Okay, so I'm holding this up.
Guys, isn't this pretty? Okay, so I'm gonna put this around my wrist here, and we're gonna kind of guesstimate what that looks like. Okay, so here, put this up so you can see it a little bit easier. So here, I'm gonna take all four of my strands. I'm lining these babies up, okay? And I'm going to take that overhand knot. Okay, so I've taken all four of my strands and I'm flipping them all through and then tying them all together here. Okay, pulling a couple. We want it to be kind of close to the ends of all of these beads. But like I said, you know, a little movement is not terrible. Not everything needs to be perfect. This is a great example of that. Now I'm just pulling each one tight. Okay, so that ends all of our strands here. Okay, the next thing we want to do is we want to guesstimate the button area here. So I'm going to bring you back around here while we do this next part. Okay, so we tied all of those together. Now we're going to kind of put the button here. And we're going to want that other knot to be right here. Okay? Strands is very, very short, so I'm going to go a little bit tighter just to make the knot, and then I will loosen it up. So I'd give yourself, I was just kind of eyeballing when I cut it, but see, I haven't tightened it completely here, but I want enough so this button will fit through. And that looks like it's pretty good. Okay, so I'm gonna tighten all that up. Okay, now if you guys want, you could put some little beads here at the bottom. So let's see. So that's one, and then I'll cut that to length. And I kind of like them doing them all different sizes too. So I'm gonna just choosing beads that I used in the bracelet here, tying these little overhand knots on the very end. Missing one. There's that. And this is going to be a tough one. I don't know if I can get that one looped around. We're going to see if I can make that happen. I don't know. I might have made that one a little smidgen short. And that happens.
this around here. I don't think I'm gonna be able to get it. But you guys get the idea here. I'll mess with that a little bit later. But you can see all the little ends. We can clip those babies off. Okay, and in case they're just a little too long for you, we'll take that little dab of glue. That super new glue, awesome stuff. Okay, we're gonna dab those at the end here of these so it keeps it from fraying. And let those dry, okay? And then here, you guys, we have ourselves a beautiful, awesome new bracelet full of color. Let's flip you guys around. Let's see, this way. There, so got ourselves an awesome bracelet. Gonna open this up. I don't know why that opened like that. That was weird. Okay. That looks so pretty. Here's and I'll take a photo for you guys so you guys can see the picture of the project. This is what we made today. Thank you so much for joining me. If you guys have any questions, I can stay on for just a few minutes. So if you have any questions, I'm happy to answer them. Today we were showing, if you are just joining with us here. Hi there, you are from Pakistan. That's so cool to see the whole world joining in here in little Vienna, Virginia. Actually, Vienna is considered one of the top places in the country to live. So I guess if we're gonna be isolated, it's only because we're close to transportation and access to all of these different amenities, none of which anyone can use right now, right? But today we had a great time using leftovers. So using a button, so we used a button, a 1 millimeter cotton cording. Okay, you can use kind of a variety of different styles, and then really a variety of different styles of beads. So you can see here we use some metal beads, we use some zeros, we use some little pewter beads, all things that fit on that 1 millimeter cord. I was doing lots of color. Amazing. So thanks for joining me. If you guys want to check out some other Bead With Me's, you can see them on our YouTube channel, so please subscribe to us there. We also have things uploading quickly first, right away onto Facebook, onto the video library. And remember that if you like the things that we are using here in these videos, or if you see our ads, all of those items are available. We're not normally an online bead store, but you can virtually chat with us. We are a virtual bead store, so although our products are not online, just so that you can scroll through them, we are happy to actually work with you on a more personal level. So we want to invite you to join in the Stars Beads experience of shopping virtually and live online. So give us a call anytime. You can check in with us through Instagram or Facebook to do a social media chat anytime. And if you have questions, you can ask those anytime. Otherwise, you can video chat if you want to see things here in store. We have virtual hours between 12 and 3, Monday through Friday. If you would like some other hours, please just set up an appointment. We're happy to work with you. And it's really nice to at least pick up, and you know you're not going to get a bot or a robot. So if you do write to us and you get a bot message back, we will be replying to you fairly quickly. Okay, so feel free to write us. We really like interacting. We really
need to have some social time. So this is about the only time that we do get. Otherwise, every so often, at least when you guys are doing curbside pickup, I get a little quick hi and bye through the window. So thanks for joining me. We look forward to seeing you guys tomorrow. And oh, JC, it's so great to see you. You're moving back. Oh, that's so wonderful. But now you can call me just like this, so it'll be like a real live person, and you can chat with me, you can show me what you guys are working on. So it's really helpful being on here. So if you are always thinking, oh, I wanted to take this piece of jewelry and you know, showcase so that I can see what parts I need, you can do that and you won't forget it because you'll be at home, right? So I can video chat. For those that want to hide and just want to see the things that I have on this end, feel free. We can call, you can block out the video, and I'm just happy to show you the things on this side, okay? So thanks for joining me again, you guys. We look forward to seeing you guys tomorrow, hopefully at 2:00, but make sure your Facebook lives are just on there. I am kind of a one-woman show here in the shop, so I am taking phone calls, doing video chats, and so sometimes my lives are running a little off time. So just make sure you are catching them. My aim is always 2:00 each day, and we will look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Tomorrow is Work It Wednesday, so I may offer a time so that you can join me. So feel free if you want to have a project and ask some questions, or if you want to send over some questions right here down below in the comments, or send us a personal message. That way then we can help you out and maybe answer questions that other viewers may have. Have a great day. See you tomorrow.